You see, my grandma wasn't always this fragile. Back in her day, she was a strong, independent woman that brought her family from the Philippines to the United States of America.
Living is a dream when you make it seem enchanted. Lovers take for granted.
In 1966, when we are both working in one company, I'm the one who planned to come here. And but I told him to come here first because we don't have enough money for both of us and the 3 kids. I just want to come here because I know it will be good for us. So, and the kids are still, I think Didit is 9 years old, 7, Bibot, and Blissy is 5.
I did not want to leave at first because I did love the Philippines, especially where we lived in the province. I remember that my grandma and my aunts telling us not to ever forget them. Mm-hmm. And also for her to be alone with 3 kids, I know that she had to be the mom and the dad for all of us. And I thought that was really strong of her to do that, because I don't think I could do that.
I think she's the strongest person I know. I mean, she lives alone. She's in her 70s. She's disabled because, you know, the accident. I think that's pretty strong. I don't know if I would be able to do that.
She did everything on her own. So with that, I'm very thankful. And when we moved to the U.S., unfortunately had to raise us alone again because my dad had a stroke when he was 57, and I was a junior in high school, and my little sister, Diane, we're 10 years apart, had to grow up without a dad. She didn't have anybody else to rely on, so that was hard.
Out of my 3 sisters, I am the youngest, and I was born here in America. I remember staying in the van sometimes, and she was working 2 jobs, and so there's times where I didn't see her a lot. God, I'm gonna cry now.
So maybe next time, when you talk to your grandma, think about her story and what it took to get you to where you are today.